Hello everyone, this is S. Ziauddin. I welcome you all for the fourth video on Sun and Planet Gears. In this video, we are going to solve a different Sun and Planet arrangement where the planet is called as a spider arm. Okay, let's move on to the description of the problem. Now this is the description of the problem. We have an annulus A. Now what is annulus? Annulus is another name for internal gear. It is another name for internal gear. So if internal gear is given, and what is the direction of rotation of its mating gear? Yes, you are correct. If internal gear is given, the direction of rotation of the mating gears will be same as that of the internal gear. So one such annulus is given with a speed of rotation of 300 rpm about the fixed wheel S. Here S stands for sun in the gear arrangement, which has got 18 number of teeth. Now we have three armed spider. So this is what I said in the intro. So this three armed spider is another name for planet. So in the previous two videos we discussed about sun and planet gear arrangement. Here we have a three planet arrangement. Now we have a three planet arrangement. So you can see in the picture, this is the first planet, this is the second planet, this is the third planet. Now these three planets are identical, equal in geometry, number of teeth, and these three are connected with the help of a webbed, spider webbed arm. So in that way it is called as spider shaped arm or spider arm, or it is called as simply a planet. So the three armed spider is a planet. Now we have an arm whose direction of rotation is given as 180 rpm. Now the question is, we need to find the number of teeth, that is number of teeth on the planet P. So this is the question. This is the question part. Once again, let's move on to the picture. You have two views, figure A and B. So simultaneously look at both the views so that you will have a clear understanding about the arrangement of this type of sun and planet gears. You have a central sun gear. So you can see here as well as in the figure B, central sun, and you have outer annulus. This is called as annulus with internal teeth. Now we have a planet. This is planet which is mentioned here. We have three such planets, but these three planets will move in unison, which means its speed will be same, geometrically same, number of teeth is same. And of course you have arm A, where you cannot visualize in the figure B. Better go to figure A, where you can easily visualize the arm. Now the animated version of this gear train is given in the link in this video. So if you go to the YouTube, at the bottom of this video, so there is a description. So I've shared the animated version of this gear train arrangement. Just click on and you can visualize how the arrangement look like. Now to solve this epicyclic gear train, like any other gear train, first we need to identify the number of, yes, you are correct, the number of elements, the number of elements. Now if you count on the number of elements, you have a central sun. Sun is in mesh with planet. You can see the geometry. Sun is in mesh with planet. This planet is in turn mesh with the internal gear A. So these three forms the three element, and of course we have arm A, small a. So in total we have got four number of elements, because in epicyclic gear train the number of element is first and foremost important. Based on this number of element only, based on this number of element only, we'll be solving the unknowns. So we have got four number of elements. So let's move on to the table of motion. Now in the table of motion, we have three rows. If you see my earlier videos, three videos, so it is very much similar to that one. So we need to open three rows. These three rows are common for any epicyclic gear drive. And of course, these two columns also, serial number and action of elements also fixed. Now, the number of additional columns here depends on the number of elements. In our problem, we have got four elements. Therefore, we need to open four columns. We need to open four columns. Now the first column is dedicated to the speed of arm A, or another word is called as revolution of arm A. Second column is for the sun S. Third column is for the planet P, the spider webbed, three identical. So that planet is mentioned here as a single column. And last you have the internal gear or annular wear. Annular gear, or it is called as annulus, which is the fourth one. So like the previous problem, we need to assume or we need to start that in such a way that fixing the arm. If you see my previous three videos, the same. So we are going to fix the arm, which means the speed of arm is zero. The speed of arm is zero. So that is filled in this space, in this cell. Next, we need to assume the first element, that is sun V less plus one revolution. Now in our series of videos, we assumed that counterclockwise is, can you remember? Counterclockwise is positive, yes. Counterclockwise is taken as positive in my series of videos, especially for solving the epicyclic gear train. For epicyclic gear train, we assume that counterclockwise is positive and clockwise will be negative. So therefore, the sun wheel is assumed as plus one revolution clockwise, which is filled here. The meaning of this is, we assumed that the speed of sun is plus one. So this is filled in this column, this column. Next, we need to fill this space and this space. How to find the revolution of P as well as the last one revolution of A? Let us go to the arrangement. Now you have sun. You have sun. This sun is in immediate contact with planet P. Therefore, we need to take the meshing pair S and P. S and P. Now, S and P are rotating in opposite direction. S and P. That is sun and planet are moving in opposite direction. Therefore, the speed of the planet is given by this relation. The speed of the planet, Np by Ns is equal to minus Ts by Tp. Where comes this minus? Where comes this negative sign? You can see the text which is highlighted in yellow. If S is positive, P will be negative because S and P are, that is sun and planet are external gearing arrangement. So whose direction of rotation will be opposite to each other, opposite to each other. Now from the table of motion, in the table of motion, we assumed Ns as 1, that is plus 1. Therefore, this plus 1 comes here, and if you cross multiply, Np will be simply minus Ts by Tp, minus Ts by Tp. In the question, the number of teeth on S is given as 80. Therefore, we need to substitute that. So, if you substitute Ts 80, at last, we have got this thing. That is, the speed of planet Np. The speed of planet Np is minus 80 by Tp. So, take this value and put it here. Take this value and put it here, minus 80 by Tp. So we have done the third empty space, that is for the third column, that is third additional column, revolution of P. Next is revolution of A. Revolution of A. Once again go to the geometry. A is in mesh with P. You can see A is in mesh with P. Therefore, you have to write the speed of A in terms of P. So, the speed of A is given here. The speed of A is given in terms of P here. Na by Np is Tp by Ta. And again, read this text given in yellow. A is an annular wheel, that is internal gear arrangement. So, in case of internal gear, in case of internal gear arrangement, the direction of rotation of the mating gears are identical or same. Therefore, P is negative, therefore A is also negative. That is what we have used negative sign again. We have used negative sign again. I will repeat. In case of internal gears, the direction of rotation of the mating gears will be same. A is in mesh with P. And what is the direction of rotation of P? That is V, it is negative. Therefore, the direction of rotation of A is also negative. Therefore, we used negative symbol here. So, we have Na by Np is equal to this equation. Na by Np is equal to minus Tp by Ta. What is Np? We don't know Np, whereas Np is given in terms of Tp. Bring it here. Bring it here. So, Na is, this equation, Na is Np into minus Tp by Ta, and Np is here, which is given on the third line of this this slide. Now we have minus, listen here, minus At by Tp into Tp by Ta. Now this Tp and this Tp cancel each other. Therefore, we have got Na as minus At by Ta. Na as minus At by Ta. So, therefore, the speed of annulus is brought here. We need to fill in this space. Now, this completes the first row or first step. Once again, I seek your attention. In solving epicyclic gear drive problem, the first row is very, very, very important. This row is very, very important. If you are able to crack the first step, you have done with the problem. So, at the end of the first step, we have a revolution of A, that is arm, small a as 0. Revolution of sun, that is S, as plus 1. Revolution of P as minus At by Tp. A revolution of A as minus At by Ta. What is the second step? Will you remember that? Yes, you are correct. We need to multiply that with x. We need to multiply each and every value with x. If you multiply this with this, you will get 0. If you multiply this with x, you will get plus x here. If you multiply this value with x, you will get minus 80x by Tp. And you have the last value. If you multiply this with x, you will have this value, minus 80x by Ta. So, second step is very simple. Very simple. You have to multiply each and everything by plus x. So, there is a mistake here. It should be plus x here. It is plus x here. Plus x. What is the third one? Third step, you need to add plus y here. Yes. So, you have to add plus y. It results in 0 plus y is plus y. Now, you have to add plus y here as well. So, this results in plus y plus x. You need to add plus y here. So, this results in plus y minus 80x by Tp. You have to add plus y in the last column, and you have plus y minus 80x by ta. Therefore, at the end of third step, we have speed of revolution of as plus y, speed of revolution of sun s plus x plus y, speed of revolution of p, that is planet, plus y minus 80x by tp, and the speed of revolution of annulus a is plus y minus 80x by ta. So these values are based on our assumption. Arm is fixed, s goes for plus 1 revolution, then next we'll be multiplying that with x, and we'll be adding that with x. Now we need to find the unknowns. Yes. It is given in the question. If you look back, the speed of arm is 180 rpm. It is the statement which is given in the question. The speed of arm, n suffix small a, is 180 rpm. Therefore, from the table of motion, the speed of arm is here. This one. It is plus y. Therefore, plus y is taken as plus 180. Where comes this plus 180? Again, read this instruction. In the direction of rotation, in the question, the direction rotation of arm is not given. Therefore, we assumed that it is counterclockwise. It is not given in the statement. Therefore, we assume it is counterclockwise. So we got ys plus 180. Now, if you go back to the statement again, ys, that is sun is fixed, ns is fixed, which means the speed of sun is zero. If you look at the table of motion, you can see this is the speed of sun, that is plus y plus x. So from the table of motion and from the statement, we equated the speed of sun as plus y plus x equal to 0. Already we have y is 180. This will give x as minus 180. So we have got x value as well as y value based on the two statements, that is speed of arm small a and the speed of sun, based on the assumption, that is from the table of motion as well as from the statement. And the third data given in the question is annulus A is rotating at 300 rpm. Annulus caps A, n suffix caps A is 300 rpm. Now from the table of motion, this is the speed of the annulus n suffix caps A, which is plus y minus 80x by ta. So therefore plus y minus 80x by ta is taken as plus 300. Where comes this 300? Again, read this instruction. The direction of rotation of annulus A is once again not given in the question. Therefore, we assume this is counterclockwise. Therefore, it is brought here. We know the value of y, value of x. So, value of y is plus 180. Value of x is minus 180. Substitute all the values, cross multiply, simplify. You will end up with TA. Therefore, the number of teeth on A, that is annulus, is 120. Now we need to move on, because the question is about the number of teeth on the planet. Now to find the number of teeth on the planet, we need to go to the geometry of the gearing arrangement. We need to go to the geometry of the gearing arrangement. What is the geometry? Here. If I measure the center of rotation of all the gears up to this point, this will be taken as pitch circle radius of the annulus A. So this is the summation of this thing, which is pitch circle radius of the sun plus twice the pitch circle radius of the planet. You can see this one. So pitch circle radius of annulus caps A is pitch circle radius of sun plus twice the pitch circle radius of the planet. So we have got this relation based on the geometry. So please watch my third video where I mentioned how to take the pitch circle radius based on the geometry. So we have solved one problem there. So that relation is brought here. So Ra is equal to twice Rp plus Rs. What is R? We know that R, that is pitch circle radius, whether it is a small r or capital R, it is immaterial. Pitch circle radius is R is mt by 2. Now in this question, module is not given. Therefore, we assumed this m. What is this m? M stands for module. Module is assumed as constant. It is assumed as constant. So if you replace R with mt by 2 and cancelling module and by 2, you will end up with this relation. R is equal to 2rp plus rs. R in terms of number of t. Ta is equal to 2tp plus ts based on this relation. Now we know Ta. What is Ta? Which is 120 teeth. And Tp is unknown. Ts is given in the question as the statement, which is 80. So if you substitute Ta and Ts, we will get the number of teeth on the planet as 20. Number of teeth on the planet as 20. Therefore, in this problem, what is a specialist? You have a webbed or star-shaped planet, identical, therefore that can be taken as a single unit. Also, you have to consider the geometry of the gearing arrangement based on which you applicate some unknowns. Hope you are following the videos. Once again, I thank you all for watching my video. Thank you.